profile of mine, there you have many options. Like first of all, you can choose to make your profile visible to everyone or only trusted parties or only to yourself. If you want your profile to be viewed by everyone, then you can make it to this green, everyone. Who can see this means all the details what you're uploading, just like privacy settings, it will be available in all the data what you're entering in your profile. It will be asked whether it has to be shown for everyone or only to your parties whom you trust or only to yourself, not to anyone, something like that. So you can have, first if you come to about, it will have, it will display your asset ID here. So these things, all the edit options, see here, you can edit all your data here. You can give your keywords regarding your domain of research or your practice keywords, or what's the main area of research or what's most of your work would be around. You can give those as your keywords. This would be asked in most of the journals while creating a profile. Similar to that, the OSCE also asks about regarding the keywords. Then you can give your all social links, websites and social links. If you have your own website, you can give the link over here. Or if you have the socials links like Facebook or Twitter or Insta, every links you can make it over here. Other IDs which would be of much use is you can give your Scopus author ID, you can create one. And you can give, in MDPI, they have something like Sci profiles. This you can link with the ORCID. And researcher ID, it is for the Publons. So these are the IDs what you can link with your ORCID. So once your publication gets published with the ORCID ID link, it will be automatically updated in your profile. That's the first dictum behind creating this ORCID ID, because in every recognized or trusted publications, they get your all ORCID IDs during the enrolling or during the submission part of your manuscript itself. So the submitting author has to give the ORCID ID of all the contributing authors, so that once the paper gets published, you can see that in a paper, it will be like some this green ID kind of mark will come, which notes that the paper is ORCID ID linked. So all the authors who have contributed to that concerned paper will be automatically linked in their profile to that concerned paper. So if I'm submitting a manuscript, it is getting published and I have also submitted my ORCID record, ORCID ID over there. So I need not go and update every time my ORCID profile for that concerned publication. It will be automatically updated. You will get a mail from ORCID stating that so-and-so publication has been updated in your profile automatically. Something like that, you will get a mail. I can show you that. ORCID will keep on updating you about all the updations that happens to your profile. So you can get mails from ORCID stating that record has been updated. You see something like this, an update notification will come. So and so ORCID ID person, you got a notification that one of your paper has been added to your profile, something like that. If it is a work means it's a publication. So it will be added. Even if you do a peer review or if you have an editorial record, all the records which has your ORCID ID linked will be added to your profile. You have all kind of updation which will happen automatically once your ORCID ID is mentioned in all the places where you do your publication. So next, first you have to update all your personal details. Like you can give a biography, any single liner or whatever you want, and all your current and past employments, you can fill it up. You can just click on to add employment and ask for your organization, your city, your country, which department you belong to, what's your title or role over there. And if you have your own URL for that organization, you can give that. And if you're filling for the past role, what you have been played in the previous place of work, you can give start and end date. But if it is a current place of work, you can give only the start date and leave the end date blank. So it will be the current working place. So mine is medical college, hospital, Dindigul. That is the current working place. Rest of the things are all from and to will be there. Here it will be stating that from June 2021 to present. Rest of all are past records of your workplace or employment. Similar to that, you can give your educational details also. Just you can give add qualification or add education, whichever you feel is okay. If it is a qualification, you have to say which organization you took it, which city, country, department, role, the same kind of thing. And if it is a education, it will ask what university, what degree it is, such kind of things. And from which period you did that course, something like that. So you can add all your educational qualifications. Everything will be recorded in the next section. So this will be covered in education qualification. First part will be the employment part. Next one will be invited positions and distinctions. You can give your all society roles or any awards you have received, whatever it is, you can add it as either an ad, distinction. You can go give who has given you that award, where it is given, when it is given. And if you have any URL linking to that award ceremony, you can give that and the date when you were awarded that. So these things you can add to distinction. The other is the invited position. You can go and update your position in any organization or any society. You have some post which you need to be updated in your profile. You can do that here. It's an organization, city. This is the same thing. This is a topographical location and your current role in that organization. These things will be updated over here. So this is for the invited positions and distinctions what you have. And next comes the memberships and service what you provide. All the organizations where all you have life membership or an associate membership or whatever it is, you can fill in all the membership details over here. You can just click on to add membership and it will show you this which organization and what is a membership type. Either it's a life member or annual member or associate member or whatever it is. You can give that as add membership. Add service, you can add. You know, if you are working in a place and there you are giving a private practice or you are giving some service to the people, you can have that detail also updated in your profile. That accounts for the service and membership category. So next to that, funding. If you have received funding for any project or if you have any ongoing project which is being funded or past project has been given any grants, you can all state that in the place for funding. There you can just click on to add funding. If you have any link that has already been available or any site which has stated your funding details, you can just link to that site alone. Or you can manually add it by giving all the details, who had awarded, how much it has been awarded, when it was awarded, either it's a grant or it is a fund or something like that. All the details will be asked here and you can add that. For all the data what you're giving, you have to choose whether it has to be shown to everyone or only to your trusted people or to yourself only and not to everyone. You can choose this. And if you have done, you have written something by mistake and you don't want to edit it, you can edit it from here. Edit my version. You can do that here. And you can also delete the record if you don't want to. Any record for that matter, it will have this. And here there will be a thing called preferred source. Because it will be mostly useful in this works category because we will close up with this funding. Let's come to work. So work relates to a lot of things like your publications or your public article or book or whatever it is, which has an digital object identifier or any link to site to it. You can do it in this works category. In the works category, what happens is ORCID automatically updates your record. And if you unknowingly add that record manually also, so it will show here preferred source. So for this concern article, there are two sources of which it is showing the cross-reference. So this is a cross-reference platform which automatically integrates your work to the ORCID ID. So usually the more than the manual entry, what you do yourself, all the cross-ref and all the other automatically detection platforms will be given more preference. So that is the one which is being shown here. So for this work, there is only a single source. So it doesn't show any options here. So here they have two sources. So that's why it's showing as preferred source. This is shown out of two, something like that. So how to do this? If there are many ways to get your publications linked to your ORCID profile. First of all, if your ORCID profile is linked during the publication stages or in the manuscript submission stage, or at least in the pre-proof stage, then that's not a problem. It'll automatically be accounted to the ORCID profile of yours. So you have a publication which is listed in PubMed or Embase or whatever database it is, but still you don't get it in your ORCID profile. So how to do that? There are ways to do that. You can see here, you can add with state just giving your PubMed ID alone. That is a possibility. Say you have some around 150 publications which is listed in PubMed, which is all before this ORCID profile era. So you don't have your ORCID profile linked to all those publications, but still you want to get it done here. You can just do that simply. You go to PubMed. I'm just giving an example for PubMed. You can, whatever database it is, just give your author name. So it lists all your publications over here. What you can do is, you can just download the, you have the option here to add your works as BibTeX. That's a kind of exporting, like reference exporting format. So you can just download it, send to or you can save. Yeah, that is a saving is the easiest way. You can save it as a CSV. You don't want all results. All results, you can take the PubMed format. Okay, then you can create a file. So the citations download, so citations get downloaded here. Then you go to go to the RSIF. You just click onto this add works, and then you just import it. That's it. All your publications will be added here. That is one way of doing it. If you have more number of publications which needs to be added to your profile, one other way how it can be done is just simply add your DOI. That will do the work. So all your work will be automatically recognized from the DOI, and all the metadata of that concern article will be automatically taken into account. So you don't have, if you have a DOI, the job is easy. If it is cited in PubMed, then it's easy. If it is not, you can just import it via something like this, what I have done here. You can totally import all the references into one file and then import it as a BibTeX file. That is easy. But if you don't have any of these options available for your publications, you can do it manually. Definitely, you can do that. What you have to do is you have to fill in all the data by yourself for every publication. That is the only thing what has to be done. It is time consuming, but it is possible. You have to state whether it's a publication or it's an any conference data or it's an intellectual property. Then work type. If you fill in, it will come. Publication, if you fill, then it will come. What kind of publication? You can just say it's a journal article. Then you give the title of the article here. These are all not mandatory. Journal title you have to give. And then publication date you have to give. And then you give the citation. If you go to PubMed, it will give all citation formats. You just check one of the format, APA format. You give the citation over here. That is enough. And then you will have the DOI. It will give the options like, if you just give DOI, it will say. There are many options of identification it will be available. The most common one is DOI. So we usually choose DOI. You give the DOI and give the DOI value here. It will automatically pick up the URL for that concerned DOI. And it will be updated. And you can give the same URL will be copied here. And the language and the country of publication. These all metadata details has to be manually updated if you are doing it manually. But usually it will be done automatically if you choose any of these works, any of these methods. Like simply you go and add a DOI, it will do all the job for you. Just we can see a sample. It is already updated, but still we can try it. Just copy the DOI of this. If you go and put it over there, if you give retrieve work details, it must see it has automatically picked up everything. All your publication, journal article, the title, what journal it is, when it is published, citation format, and all the DOI value, URL, ISSN number, everything it will be automatically taken in. So this is the convenience what you have if you are having any of this thing available to your publication. If you don't have, it may be time consuming, but still you can do it manually. So these are the possibilities in which you can update your publication records in your RSIF, which is not automatically linked already. So make sure that whenever you get your article published in the future, get your all your articles RSIF linked so that it will be automatically updated. Mostly the Springer or any renowned publishers are doing this, and even our InnoPub also does this. They get your RSIF profile linked. All your publications are linked to your RSIF profile. So this is not a tiresome job if it is available in any one of our databases. And next is peer review. So you have options to include your peer review also. The thing is, once you make a connection between your PubLaunch and RSIF diary, because PubLaunch has a settings for this. I'll just show you. You just go to your private dashboard. Just ask me to sign in. Okay, we will sign in first. We will first sign in, and if you go to settings in your account, in settings you go to the account, and in your account you can see all your connected accounts. You can see that my RSIF is already connected to my PubLaunch. If you have not done that, you can do that. You can see the RSIF logo here. I have not connected my account to WeChat since I'm not using it. If you have not connected your RSIF ID, it will be linked here. It will be stated here stating that RSIF ID is not yet linked. So you just go and click onto that icon, then it will ask your RSID profile number alone, RSID ID alone. You just give that ID. So now the Publons will be linked to your RSID. So whatever review what you do and the credit what you get in Publons will automatically get updated to your RSID profile. These are all things automatically updated from my Publons to RSID. I have not done this anything, but it is already automatically done. You can see I have done a review 2021. If you want details, it will show the details of it. These are some IDs, what it shows. It is taken from Publons. It shows here. So similar data will be taken, will be updated for every review what I do. So this is the records. All my peer review records are over here. So these are the data what you can update in your RSID profile. So peer review data, you need not worry. You just link your Publons. And if you have done a lot of peer review already, but you don't, but all your future review will be added to your RSID ID. That is not a problem once you link it. But all your previous records, which has been, which is now available in Publons, can also be linked to your RSID. That is also a possibility. How you can do that, I'll show you. You can see, we'll go return to Publons. You just go to your profile. Settings, profile. Okay. No, it's not in profile. Permissions, sorry. You go to permissions. If you go to permissions, you can check this on because many of the journals are partnered with Publons. So you don't have to actually send all your mails to reviews@publons.com and get it added to your Publons profile. Most of the reviews what you do in renowned publishers will be automatically updated to Publons disregard to whether you make any move or any measure to get it updated in your Publons. Because while doing the review itself, you'll be asked whether you need a Publon credit for this consent peer review. If you just check that to yes, then it will be automatically updated to your profile. So for that to happen, you have to make this checkbox on. And you see here, RSID settings. You have, you, since my account is already linked to RSID, it is being shown here that I have a linked RSID account. You can check all these boxes. Keep my publication list up to date with my RSID record. If any of your RSID linked publication is not being updated in your Publons, this can be done. Because if you check this on, any record that comes to RSID will be cross-referenced with Publons. And if it is not available in Publons, it will be updated. So you don't have to duplicate the work of adding once to RSID and the next time to Publons. So this will shorten your time and your work. And this is one other option. Keep my RSID publication list up to date with my Publons. See, now you have, you don't, you have created new RSID ID. So you don't have any of your data in your RSID ID, but your Publons is up to date, or Web of Science has already searched all your publications and grouped it under your profile name, and your Publons ID is ready. So you can just check this box. All your Publons data will be transferred to your RSID. So it will all be made available to your RSID. See, now it says that you have 58 eligible publications which can be exported to your RSID profile, including 57 which has already been exported and may be updated. Only one of my publications not yet updated. So if you just give export publications to RSID now, if you say that, great, we have started updating your publications on RSID. This will be done in no time. So you need not worry at all. It will be automatically done. Next is export reviews to RSID. This is so you have to keep this checkbox on so that all the reviews what you do and get credit from Publons will be automatically updated to your Publons account. Sorry, to the RSID profile. So you have 143 verified pre-publication reviews which can be exported to RSID, including 142 which has already been exported. So only one of my peer review is not yet updated in RSID, which I can do it now. So we have started updating. So that's all. Just a click away, you can update all your profile in a go. So this you can revoke the permission. This you need not do that, but still they have an option to revoke the permission to sync between the RSID and Publons. That's all. You can save changes and then close it. Then all your Publons data will be automatically updated to RSID. So in this way, you can get all your Publons data into RSID. Okay. So now we will go to, so RSID, I think so it must be clear for you to update all this data in your RSID profile. And now we will go to Publons. So Publons, once you log in, you have this dashboard in this dashboard, in your records, you have only three things what can that can be done in Publons to that needs to be done by you. So you can go to publications. So in publications, if any of your publication is having an OSIP link, or if it is listed in Web of Science database, it will be automatically picked up. Once you give publications, this screen will tell you how many Web of Science identified publication of yours is not yet linked to your profile. So just if you give import publications, it will automatically import what this will. This actually will show here you have two publications detected by Web of Science which is not yet been updated to your profile. Something like that. Notification will come here, and if so, if you just give OK, then it will automatically get updated. That's it. And all the updated publications will be listed here. Will be shown here in the bottom. If you want to find anything which is you want to check whether a concerned publication is added to your profile or not, you can just give a search either using the title or the journal name or the author name or the period when it has been done. In such way, you can search your all added publications and make sure that all your publications are accounted for here. Next, what are the methods in which you can import the publications? So Publons give you a lot of freedom to do that. One simplest way is syncing with OSIP. Just sync with your OSIP. One go, it will update all your OSIP updated records to Publons. The other way, what we have done there, you can give your DOI or article title. It will automatically update it. You just check it here. Just give your DOI and click it. If I say publication, it will say that I have already an author of this publication, so I have already added this, so it's not needed now. So this is the way how it has to be done. Just give your DOI or PubMed ID here, or your article title, whichever you have in your hand which is not yet updated in Publons, then it will show the metadata of that concerned publication. If you just give the DOI and wait, it will show you all the metadata details. So if it is not already saved, you can say save publications and it will be saved. So that is the way in which how it can be done. So this one has to be done one by one. So in a similar way, you can do this here in the way of how I have told you from PubMed. Yeah, you can just export all your publications. You can export all your publications as a single file. You have the liberty to do it in three formats. You can do it in RIS mode or CSV mode or BibTeX mode, whichever mode you want. You can just save the file and then you just select the file. You just say upload. All your publications will be updated in a single go. This is the easiest way to do that. If you have many publications which are listed in a database which has not yet been updated in Publons, this is the easiest way to do that. So in this way it can be done, and this is the way. These are the four possible ways in which Publons give us ways to update our publications. This is for regarding updating our publications. Next, regarding the peer review. So regarding the peer review, the easiest way to do that is to mail them. More than adding it manually, that is the easiest way to do that. I'll show you how it is done. You just go, if you get a acknowledgement mail from see something like this. Wait, before that, once you have done a peer review and you get an acknowledgement mail from the peer review for thank you for your review, something like that. Something like this. Once you have done a peer review, then it will be stated that thank you, your review has been taken. Something like that. You'll get an acknowledgement mail, and after that an acknowledgement mail, you just forward it to Publons. Then they will automatically update it after a waiting period and screening period. That will be around a day or two, mostly. Nothing more than that. Here, thank you for submitting your review, so and so. You just forward to the mail ID reviews@publons.com. That's it. If you give reviews at Publons, then send. That's all. If you just forward this acknowledgement mail to reviews, this is a mail ID. Everyone must be knowing it. reviews@publons.com. This is the mail ID for updating your peer review records. So if you have done that, then immediately Publons will give a mail stating that we have received your request and we will process it and we will get back to you. Something like that, a mail will come. See, it has come stating that we are processing your review and you are 4495 in the queue and you will be responded in 2 days and 21 hours. So after this wait period, we can see our record being updated on our profile. If you want to check how many records are pending in that way in our profile, you can go to pending records. So now we have submitted one. So that will be listed. See, that is listed stating that it will be done in 2 days and the current position and the status. This is in this way you can check how many records are pending for approval in Publons. So in this way you can do the peer review, all your peer reviews being added to your Publons record. The other thing what much of our editors are not making account into is the editor records. You handle some article as an editor, you assign it to some peer reviewers. After receiving comments from the peer reviewers, you make a decision about the manuscript and you finalize whether it has to be published or rejected or whatever may be the nature of the result. You are the person who is personally handling that concerned publication. So you will be given a credit in Publons for handling all your editorial works. So for that, in editor records, you can add those data also. If you are in a manuscript and if you are handling a manuscript, this is regarding our journal, what I have asked personally to give me an acknowledgement mail for all the editorial work what I have done for our IJOR journal. So they have sent me a similar acknowledgement mail what we get for peer review for editorial work also. So if you just forward it to, there is a mail ID for that also. There we have reviews@publons.com. Here editor@publons.com, something like that. I'll check you and tell you. Yeah, something like this. You'll get thank you for reviewing. This is for review.
The
something.
The email for the editor is edits@review. edits@publons. It is not the editor. It is just edits@publons.
Okay, edit at publons.
Edits. EDITS. That's it. Edits.
We can share this or email ID on
the
email.
Now you will get it.
Yes, sir.
Definitely, you get an acknowledgement like thank you for thank you as a handling editor to the journal and the concerned manuscript. You can get an acknowledgement mail like this and you just forward it to them. edits@publons.com. You will forward it to them and they will add all your data to your Publons profile. And in this way, you can have all your editorial records added to your profile. And these are the data what you can upload to update your profile. And I think this sums up about updating all your records. HNX will be automatically calculated. Your reviews will come here. Your editorial records will come here. Citation will be automatically calculated. So the publications, you will be adding it. Either Web of Science will be automatically adding all those publications or you can do it manually also. How we can do it manually is you can just search for the concerned article title. You can just give the title. If you don't have the data for the concerned article to be added to your profile, you can just search that article in Publons. Yeah, you can see publications in the under the publications. If you see, it will be showing your publication and you can see all the authors who have claimed that publication. You must, if you are not an author, if you are an author and you have not claimed that concerned publication, you can just search the title of that article in Publons and you can go and claim yourself that this is one of your article and you can claim it. If you are not already claimed it, you will see an icon here that claim this publication, something like that. You can just go and claim it. That's it. And the article will be added to your profile.
Yeah.
So this is one way of adding your publications to the Publons record. So what other data that can be added to this profile. That's it. We have covered everything, I guess. Okay. Rest of all, yeah. You can add your publications in this way, the peer review records in that way, and the editorial records by edit set of blogs. Any doubts?
Yes, sir. There are three.
Registering in SAI profile or Scopus profile, they make it a mandatory account to get your RSID ID. So once you give your RSID ID to a Scopus account, it will automatically get linked. Or you can do that manually by adding it here. Any Scopus or MDPI or Research ID, whatever you do it here. So Research ID is nothing but Publons. If you just go to Publons, you will see that this is a Research ID. So this states that Publons and RSID are linked. In that way, all your Publons account will come here. Only if you give a particular permission in your Publons stating that to update all your records to RSID. So now one is clear. So RSID, that is research, sorry, Publons, which is a researcher ID. If you give permissions to your profile to get updated to RSID also, it will be done. And I have shown you how it has to be done also. So this is done. For Scopus and MDPI profiles, SKY profiles, this actually, they have a mandatory note for all the publications for the author's RSID ID. So if you get your article published in MDPI journals, it will automatically be updated to RSID because RSID numbers will be mandatorily be requested by the editors. So all your MDPI articles will be definitely be updated here. And it will be updated here and it will also be taken up by the Web of Science and it will be updated in Publons also. You don't have to do that at all. It will be automatically updated. Most of my most of the records what I have here is not all done by me. It is automatically updated only. So you can see that all the records what is shown here, these are all automatically taken up by the Web of Science. This is LinkedIn Web of Science, Web of Science. This is the MDPI one. This is automatically taken. I have not done anything to add these publications at all. Once you ensure that all your recent publications are either RSID linked or in one way or the other linked to any one of your profiles, and if you make sure that your settings are in such a way that each other profiles communicate with each other, then it should not be a problem for you to update your profile at all. It will be automatically be handled, taken care of.